Are you sick and tired of gambling your hard-earned money on Madden packs? Well, look no further than my sponsor, MMOEXP, for the cheapest and the most reliable MUG coins on the market. And don't forget to use code FERDY at checkout for 5% off. The link for their website will be right at the top of the description. Are you looking to take your Madden game to the next level? Look no further than Civil.gg for the best ebooks on the market. Choose one of two membership options, and don't forget to use code FERDY at checkout for 25% off. What's going on, guys? For the third and final gameplay of the day, we are looking at the brand new Deion Sanders. Before we hop into it, though, if you are new here, hit that subscribe button. We are on the road to 30,000 subscribers. Hit the subscribe button, turn notifications. We post daily Madden 22 content. And today is Friday, so that does mean I will be live tonight over on Twitch, rating teams live. And if for whatever reason, if you are not able to make it to the Twitch live stream tonight, you can always send me your team into the Discord server, into the I Rate Your Teams channel. And I'm going to do three teams offline before stream, then three teams online during stream. So if you cannot make it to the Twitch stream, just drop a picture of your team or a screenshot of your team into the Discord server, into the I Rate Your Teams channel. Links for both of the Discord and the Twitch down in the description. And the shout out for today's video goes to my man Elijah. No, sorry, not Elijah. Shout out to Elijah, though. It goes to my man Cooper Beaulieu. I have no idea how to say his name, but shout out to Cooper for counting the emoji on last video. Okay, so here is the 94 overall Deion Sanders. And this card is one of those cards, I say this every single year with Deion. Guys like Deion, Lawrence Taylor, I think Derrick Henry's becoming one of these names. Bo Jackson, Randy Moss, like, I'm probably missing a couple of them, but I mean, Sean, I already say Sean Taylor, I may have. But it's cards like that, that regardless of their overall, whenever they come out, you have to get those guys on your team because of how they play in Madden. And I'm not sure what it is about Deion. This guy always is just a monster in coverage, like an absolute monster in coverage. I'm pretty sure it's because of his high COD and high agility that all his cards usually have. And I feel like a lot of people do overlook COD and agility when it comes to coverage. But yeah, Deion, 93 speed, 94 acceleration, 94 awareness, great play rec. Usually the man in the zone do match, and that's no different on this card. So 94, 93. As far as his press goes, it's fairly low, but it's better than it has been in years past. So 81 press on Deion, good catching. And against the run, he might as well not even be out there, to be honest. I would definitely play Deion outside the numbers. Don't play him in the slot, because if you put him in the slot, if he's going to do with Derrick Henry, he's going to have his way with Deion Sanders, running the ball at him every single time, just punishing him. So, yeah, 50, I mean, sorry, not even 50, 46 block shed, 44 impact block. Does have decent pursuit, so I guess if there is no blocker in his way, he will get there pretty cleanly. But what he's going to do when he's at the ball carrier might not be pretty, because, you know, not the best tackling, no real hit power, and no real strength either. And also the card is only 185. He is 6 foot, so a good height, but in coverage, Deion is one of the best step-for-step corners in this game right now, easily. Like, the Deion cards always play glitchy in coverage. So for the abilities today, Deion is gonna be getting Acrobat. I'll be using Acrobat today, but that's pretty standard. I feel like it's either gonna be mid-zone or Acrobat on Deion. Does get Lurker 2 AP as well, Spin Cycle, all that good stuff. 1 step, 4 AP if you wanna go that route. But those are the abilities for Deion. And for team chems, he does get Falcons, Niners, Cowboys, Washington football team, and the Ravens. So some pretty good teams right there for Deion. Good stats. And let's go into Madden real quick so I can show you guys what his ball carrier stats look like. And on his pre-order card, he had these crazy after the catch stats, and EA kind of stuck with it. So 99 juke with a 92 spin and a 98 break tackle for Deion. Your first instinct might be to put him at kick returner, but he's got 79 carrying, so it is kind of a risk-reward situation. Yeah, he's probably the best kick returner in the game when the ball's in his hands, but if he gets hit hard, if he gets lined up, it could get a little bit scary out there, I'm not going to lie. And they also gave him some route running, too. I believe there is a formation in run and gun that you're able to put your cornerback in at receiver, so maybe you want to go that route. But 80 short route running, 86 deep, and 82 mid, so pretty good route running as well for Deion. But yeah, after the catch stats, so if you get an interception with a 99 juke and a 98 break tackle, Deion will be making plays out there for you for sure. So that's enough talking. I've been rambling on for a minute about this card. Let's just hop into it. Let's see what Deion Sanders can do. All right, here we go. I feel like house rules is probably the best way to display Deion. Unfortunately, of course, we're going to be starting off on offense. Whenever I'm doing offensive gameplays, I start on defense. Whenever I'm doing defensive gameplays, I'll start on offense. That's just kind of how EA's been treating me this year, it feels like. It's almost every single time. But let's try to just put up a quick score. Yeah, it should be pretty easy for us. Shouldn't be that hard. Yeah, Kirk Cousins at QB still. Spin that. Yep. Okay. So just like that on offense. And I just don't believe. I mean, I'll be dropping a Jets theme team episode tomorrow. But you guys are gonna see some of the cards on this team, like the stats of them. Like,
I don't know why this theme team's so underrated, because on all the like the EA, all the EA Madden NFL tweets where they tweet out the theme team rankings, the Jets are never even on the list somehow. I don't understand how they have. I mean, I guess some of their corners are starting to phase out. I feel like they're probably like a Camardi upgrade or a Revis upgrade away from being like probably A tier in my opinion. But yeah, I don't really know. It's kind of weird that, you know, they aren't ever on any of those tier lists when I think they're one of the best in the game, like legit. And there's Dion, right side of your screen playing some match. Actually, let's press him so he's actually like kind of manned up out there. You're getting a good swim move. Get outside and don't tell me that's a PI. Don't tell me that's actually going to be a PI, right? There's no way. Oh, roughing the passer. Okay, that makes more sense. That makes more sense. I definitely rough him up a little bit. I mean, again, defensive player gameplays, especially corners. I feel like it's not always a bad thing when the opponent doesn't throw the ball a corner's way. When you think about it, I mean, that means he's playing good coverage, you know? And I'm here again. The pass rush right now is eating. And I am trying Speedster right now on Abraham, and I think I put under pressure on him as well. I do like investing a lot in my pass rush, especially when I send four a lot. I'm getting any kind of additional pressure when you're able to drop a bunch of extra dudes in the coverage, in my opinion, is a major W. But he's kind of playing, I don't like where Dion is right now, because like he's kind of playing, I got stuck up here. You might go to the back. Actually, Dion over the top. Dion Holcomb, Dion. There we go. We got to pick with Dion Sanders. And you guys saw right there, that was Dallas Goedert, so you could really see it. But Dion's recovery speed is just ridiculous. So, I mean, there's Dion making a play. Usually we do go empty in these receiver game. I mean, in these corner game plays where nothing really happens for the corner. But first game, Dion showing off his speed and his man coverage and making a great play right there. So let's just, I honestly want to try this just to see if I can really do this. I'm just going to streak Robbie Anderson. And yeah, that's toxic. I know it is. But I just want to see if I can like legitimately use this, because I mean, probably not, right? There's just no way that, okay, yeah, he's playing so far back that wouldn't make sense. That wouldn't make sense. But oh, Robbie just caught that. Okay, I apologize, man. This guy should quit. Like I'm sorry. I don't know. I'm just testing things, and it's, I don't know. That's ridiculous though, how he caught that. That's actually crazy. This is a Dion gameplay, I know, but sometimes Robbie's got to steal the I didn't mean to call that. Oh, that actually worked. Accidental hike call and a touchdown for Gronk. Wanted to go to Brandon Marshall there. We are punishing this man right now. And what was that play? I have a quick base in this. And also, I didn't really talk about it. So a really interesting ability that Dion does get this year that I should have talked about. Powered up, I believe he only does get it because I didn't see it on much EG. Is film study, which film study was an ability in last year's game. Not many people ran it. It was in the beta for Madden 21 and everyone was hype about it because it was going to punish people from running the same play over and over again. I'm not sure how it works. Does it work the same this year? I don't know. Households isn't really the place to test it out, but I'm sure we make it two Dion picks here. Oh, I tried swerving it to get a good animation. We didn't get it, but Dion playing that lockdown man-to-man coverage once again. But yeah, he does get film study, which is if an opponent calls a play like five times in a game, maybe you're able to see his play art, which is in theory glitchy, right? Like it sounds really good, but it had a weird reset in Madden 21 where it would only last for a quarter. I'm not sure how it works this year though. If it works like throughout the whole game, it could be an ability maybe worth running for 5 AP. Maybe, like I doubt it, but it's possible, I guess. But oh, that's our ball right there. This guy's trying to throw hot ones. Like you ain't like that, my guy. Let's try to hit Dion here. Get the ball to Dion. There's a juke. Oh my, get loose, Dion. Oh, I ran into dude, broke a tackle. I thought that guy behind me was gonna catch me, but Dion Sanders, that juke animation is ridiculous. That's probably where this card is the scariest. Like, bro, dude, when the ball's in his hands after a pick, I mean, good luck, man. That dude just feels glitchy. And you know Dion's drip has gotta be elite too. All right, we switched over Lawrence and we switched Lawrence and John Abraham trying to get some more. We make another Dion pick here. No, why is Edry stealing Dion's thunder? Yeah, I'm getting this ball to Dion. No, why? Why? Wait, Dion's still going to pick it up. Go get it, Dion. Make something happen. Oh, I shouldn't have cut in like that. He's broken a tackle every single time, though. And I'm almost convinced now that this dude is gone. I don't know where he went, really. But if he does get back onto his console, I will show you guys the defensive snaps. If he doesn't, I will see you boys in the outro. But shout out to Throw Him Up, 1969. That was a fun game, man. I mean, we had a Dion pick. Defense played great. I'm sure if you're here for Dion, you were watching Dion play match and play coverage and stuff as well. But yeah, Dion, even after the catch a couple times, you were able to see Dion. That card feels amazing. So I guess we're gonna be in the outro because this dude is just not here. All right, guys. So that is going to do it for the Dion Sanders gameplay. It was kind of a shorter one, but I did want to just bring you guys a little gameplay showing you guys how he plays, how he moves. how the card looks in game, how he's after the catch. And I think we accomplished all those things in today's video. So shout out to the guy we played. I think I already said that, but it was a fun one for sure. But Deion, one of the best corners in this game right now. I think it's either him or JC for debate. Can play man, can play zone. The catching's there, the agility, the COD, amazing after the catch, after the interception. Against the run, he's Deion Sanders, so we don't expect much there, but good speed. For now, I do feel like maybe like a Rob Woodson card, if they give Night Train some good speed, could definitely dethrone Deion. But other than that, I don't really know any other names. Unless they come up with some new legends, maybe they give like Cromartie just stupid good stats, I guess, if he does get a card this year. Stuff like that. But I think right now, today, the first day of Harvest, November 12th, 2021, Deion Sanders is a top two, debatably number one corner in this game right now that you should definitely go and pick up. Right now, Deion's price is actually falling it fell a little bit, then it came back up. It went down to like 380. Now it's shooting back up again. Like you see right here, no, not 380. Like it was like 390, like low 400s, which I sold my Antonio Brown back for like 340. I mean, not, sorry, 430. But yeah, I guess they're kind of sinking a little bit now. But I wonder how low these prices get. I'm really curious as to see how low they actually get. But if you are still watching, let's comment any kind of bird emoji. Let's comment the star emoji. Comment the star emoji for a chance to be shouted out in the next video. And if you are new here, hit that subscribe button for notifications. We post daily Madden 22 content. And as always, I will see you boys in the next one.